for Him Power Thought for the Day with Jim Brangenberg from I Work for Him, the voice of the faith in work movement.
How many of us think we're doing business God's way, when in reality, we're just Christians who love Jesus, go to church, and believe we live by Christian values? There's another way for us to start and run a business, to work and lead our teams, to start with God as your ultimate business partner and ask Him what His plan is, and then to keep moving based on what He's directing you to do. The mindset is to be kingdom-minded, kingdom-focused, and kingdom-motivated. When you're in this place, the business flourishes almost effortlessly. When we're doing our job in faith and obedience, the fruit is produced by God in His way and in His time. Proverbs 16:3 says, "Commit your actions to the Lord, and your plans will succeed."
For more about I Work for Him and our vision to transform the workplace of every Christian into a mission field, go to iworkforhim.com. That's iwork4him.com.
Today's June 8, 2020. This is your news to this hour. I'm Gayla Gadga for FEBC Radio. For the local news, Cebu City Mayor Edgardo Labella announced on his Facebook page that the city will soon have a bicycle lane. The local executive formed an ad hoc committee composed of former Cebu City Councilor Jerry Carrillo, City Councilor Joel Garganera, the City Transportation Office, and the Land Transportation Office to study its feasibility. Factors to be considered in the plan are the availability of road space and traffic impact. He expects the ad hoc committee to submit its study within a few days. Planning for the project will then follow once he will receive the study. In other news, several barbershops and salons reopened on Sunday amid the general community quarantine in Metro Manila. Several barbershops and salons were forced to increase prices as they grapple with the effects of the COVID-19 pandemic. While the government allowed them to resume business, only basic services such as haircuts and hairstyling can be offered to customers. Manicures and pedicures remain prohibited in areas under GCQ. Amid the new normal, barbershops and salons were required to follow strict safety protocols such as the mandatory wearing of face masks for customers and workers, wearing of personal protective equipment for workers, placement of foot baths at entrances, checking of body temperatures, frequent disinfection, and physical distancing. However, some barbershops failed to comply with the guidelines due to the cost of these health protocols. And that's the news to this hour. This is Gayla Gadia for FEBC Radio. Check your time. It's now 7:02. Good morning.
This is FEBC Philippines, communicating Christ in our world for 72 years. Now, on air and online. 1116 DXAS, San Juan da City. 1162 DXKI, Coronado City. 103.3 The New J, Cagayan de Oro City. 1197 DXFE, Davao City. 106.3 DZRK, Quezon, Palawan. 1233 DYBS, Bacolod City. Up 987 DYFR, Cebu City. 97.5 DYFE, Tacloban City. 1143 DZMR, Santiago City. CARE 104.3 The Way FM, Legazpi City. 98.7 DZFE, Metro Manila. 702 DZAS, Mega Manila. And online 24/7, Now XD and Pinoy Connection.
Inspiring, life-changing. Stand firm through the turbulence.
UP987. UP987. Encouraging. Inspiring. UP987.
Yes, this is UP987 DYFR-FM, life-changing. Good morning, Gail here. Happy to join you this Monday morning. I'll be with you till 9 a.m. As always, we're filling the air with songs and inspiration. May our broadcast perk you up, especially with what's going on. There's a lot of bad stuff happening, but amidst all these, we trust that our God is still good. So may we resolve to put our hope in Him in spite of what is happening around us. And if you want to send us messages, feel free to do so. Go ahead, text us at 0919-492-1939 or message us on facebook.com/UP987DYFRFM. Meantime, here's Joel Vaughn for I Look to You and Victory Worship for Grace Changes Everything. Good morning.
And there are days I'm so afraid, I'm so consumed with worry. Thinking about the destination, can't enjoy the journey. Praying hard, but in my heart, I wonder if you heard me. Just as I start to give up hope, I feel your spirit stirring. When the fears arise in me, I will lift my eyes to see.
Life changing.
Thank you. This small campfire using this pail of clear liquid.
So I'm going to illustrate how to properly put out a campfire?
No, Alan. The campfire represents someone who is angry. You're going to illustrate the wrong way to handle an angry person.
Oh, okay.
And action!
Okay, kids. Remember, when putting out a fire, pour the water directly on the... Whoa! Guys! Major fire here! What do I do?
Here's more liquid, Alan.
Okay! This ain't helping!
That's right, Alan. When we answer an angry person harshly, it's like pouring gasoline on a fire.
This is gasoline?
The Bible says a gentle answer turns away wrath, but a harsh word stirs up anger. When dealing with someone who is angry, we need to be gentle and answer with patience and kindness.
Oh, I get it. But was it really necessary to burn off my eyebrows to make this point, guys?
Another message from Lifeline Productions, the comic strip of radio, and lifelinepro.com.
She's holding on to hope. John lost his job 6 months ago. He's got a wife, 3 kids at home. Doesn't know what to do. He's praying for a breakthrough. Someone raise a fist up high.
Yeah. Christ, to God is giving DYFR-FM, life-changing, communicating Christ on air, online, and on the ground.
This is Ann Graham Lotz with Daily Light for Daily Living. If you think what you do in the privacy of your own home is your own business, think again. God has made it His business. You and I will experience serious consequences if we refuse to follow His leading. God gave specific directions to the children of Israel on how to raise children and how to conduct their family life. Deuteronomy 6:6 says, "These commandments are to be upon your hearts. Impress them on your children." If we don't instruct our children about God and His Word, they'll develop their own standards and values based on what they feel, what they think, what their friends do and think, what everyone else thinks and does. They will end up guessing their way through life and wind up experiencing less than God's best. Listen to me. Follow God's direction for your family, for your life, if you want to experience God's best. This is Ann Graham.
Hero of the Day.
My name is Jennifer Flores, and I'm a bank teller. I am responsible for handling customer financial transactions like deposit, withdrawals, transfer, money orders, and checking. Some clients are impatient or waiting for their turn, but the Lord reminds me, even those who don't believe the same as me, to treat them with respect and dignity. Their lack of faith or difference of faith doesn't mean that I have the right to mistreat them. In the middle of this health crisis, God has really been faithful because He gives me peace of mind. He also uses a pastor to remind me that difficulties in life are working for those who love God and against them, and our future glory is awaiting for us while our present life is guarded by God.
And our time is now 7:28 a.m. Thanks a lot for keeping it here on UP987, life-changing, broadcasting live from Emmanuel Bible College compound, Banawa Hills, Cebu City. Gail here, happy to be with you today. If you're on Facebook, well, I'm sure you've heard of multiple reports of empty, duplicate, and fake accounts. Like last Saturday night until yesterday, I've had a lot of friends who experienced this. While I haven't seen any fake account bearing my name on Facebook, I found one on Instagram. That's so creepy. So let's be vigilant, let's be careful, and make sure to report these accounts, because that's identity theft. The internet is definitely not a safe place, but nothing is safe except in the arms of our Father in Heaven. And that's something we can take comfort in amid these creepy happenings. Coming up next is Elevation Worship for the song Here Again and Loving the Outcome for You Got This. That's here on this FEDC Radio. Happy Monday.
Truth and life.
UP987 Cebu. Station manager of UP987 DYFR-FM Life Changing. Today we experience one of the most unprecedented crises in our generation. In a span of just 4 months, a tiny invisible virus compelled us to close borders, schools, businesses, and churches in more than 100 countries around the world. Many people are riddled with fear and worry at everything that's happening around us. We here at DYFR-FEBC continue the work that the Lord has started in us. We see this as an opportunity to encourage people whose hearts are now open to seek God. We bring the message of hope and peace we can have in the midst of any storm through faith in Jesus Christ. As you may already know, UP987 DYFR is a non-commercial, non-profit, and donor-supported broadcast station, and we are not spared from the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic. In fact, we now face the possibility of implementing drastic changes in our broadcast operations to be able to cope. While we continue to trust our faithful God, who is sovereign over the work that we do, we have seen His grace for the ministry through your giving. And now we ask if you would consider helping UP987 DYFR-FM stay on the air through your financial support as we look to the future. DYFR has been in operation for almost 45 years,
bringing the message of God's love to listeners here in Cebu and around the world. We fervently pray that the Lord will allow us to broadcast beyond 45 years. If you would like to join us in continuing the music and powerful biblical messages, get in touch with us through our mobile numbers 0919-492-1939 or at 0998-842-3844. You may also contact us through our Facebook at www.facebook.com/up987DYFR-FM. Thank you for your help in our mission of communicating.
Philippine Standard Time is 7:51 a.m. You're on UP987, life-changing, an FM station of Far East Broadcasting Company, Philippines. Gail here, keeping you a company till 9 this Monday morning. And we have here an encouraging message from Pastor Lalang. It says, "You are not alone. God is walking with you, and He has a plan for your life." Pastor Lalang also shares Psalm 37:23, "The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delighteth in his way." We want to say hi also to Sir Fred Pardorla. He says, "Good morning to Jojo and Lori of Powow Machine Shop, Nonok, Talisay City, Cebu. Thank you so much for tuning in and happy listening to you, Ate Janelle Gloria. I hope you guys are doing well today amid the health crisis that we're facing." Let's get back to music. Here's another local track for you, Mag Titiwala by Glory Fall, followed by Newsboys for Greatness of Our God on this FEBC Radio.
Thank you. a champion. Proverbs chapter 8, verse 14, counsel is mine and sound wisdom. I am understanding. I have strength. Today's principle is you do not have the right to anything in your life that you are unwilling to pursue. Solomon paid a heavy price for wisdom. He offered 1,000 burnt offerings unto the Lord. The Lord offered to grant the desires of Solomon's heart. But because Solomon asked for wisdom, God granted everything else Solomon could have wanted. Proverbs is the collection of wisdom Solomon passed on to us. Solomon spoke 3,000 proverbs. He wrote 1,005 songs. He mastered botany, ethology, geology, and architectural design. He mastered finances and behavioral sciences. Remember, wisdom is the principal thing. To learn more, go.
Today's June 8, 2020. This is your News to This Hour. I'm Gail Lagadia for FABC Radio. The Department of Tourism will roll out re-imaging of domestic tourism by offering tours and programs on niche markets, joining the global tourism campaign on domestic first, long haul later. Specifically, the DOT will initially promote health and wellness, farm, dive, and community-based tourism with authentic experiential activities. DOT Undersecretary Benito Bengzon Jr. said they will focus on domestic travel to jumpstart tourism in the country and to bring livelihood in tourism back. Tourism is one of the sectors badly hurt by the COVID-19 pandemic as nations around the globe shut their borders to prevent further spread. In other news, social media giant Facebook is currently investigating the reported surge of fake accounts over the weekend, which has been linked to the opposition to the controversial anti-terrorism bill. Facebook added that it is encouraging people to continue reporting accounts they believe to be fake. The Department of Justice is already gearing to launch its own investigation into the matter, which made the hashtag #HandsOffOurStudents trend on Twitter as students and alumni of various universities around the country voiced concern over the surfacing of dummy accounts in their names. And that's the news to this hour. This is Gail Lagadia for FEBC Radio. Check your time. It's now 8:03. Good morning.
Broadcasting Company Philippines, celebrating 72 years of communicating Christ in our world. On air and online, 1116 DXAS San Juan La City, 1162 DXKI Coronadal City, 103.3 The New J Cagayan de Oro City, 1197 DXFE Davao City, 106.3 DZRK Quezon Palawan, 1233 DYBS Bacolod City, up 987 DYFR Cebu City, 97.5 DYFE Tacloban City, 1143 DZMR Santiago City, K104.3 Tomoy FM Legazpi City, 98.7 DZFE Metro Manila, and 702 DZAS Mega Manila. Our message is Christ, our hope, our life. You are God.
Encouraging. Inspiring. Up 987.
Yes, this is UP987 DYFR-FM, life-changing member of the Kapisana ng mga broadcaster ng Pilipinas. Gail here, joining you till 9 this Monday morning, and we want to say hi to Jacob Lyon. He says hi also to Mac, Gina Planteras, to Marjane and Roger of People's Co-op. Have a great day, you guys. Thank you so much for tuning in today. And whatever it is you're going through, don't give up, okay? God will give you the strength and grace to get through this. Always remember that. Listen now to Plomb for the song Need You Now. I trust this will lead you to acknowledge your need of God.
Well, everybody's got a story to tell. And everybody's got a wound to be healed. And what I believe, there's beauty here. 'Cause all I get is so tired of holding on. I can't let go, I can't move on. I wanna believe.
Encouraging, inspiring, life-changing.
How great
Sometimes we get nervous when we're around someone we can see.
consider more righteous than ourselves.
Quick, you hide the magazines, I lock the movie drawer.
What?
And watch your language.
Watch my language?
Kids, stay in there and do not come out until we say.
Okay.
Dear, it's just the pastor. He's just dropping by for a quick visit.
Maybe we need to get rid of all of our champagne.
Dear, we only got sparkling cider.
Oh. Well, that explains a lot.
If you feel the need to clean up your act around a righteous person, think what it would be like to stand before a righteous God. Jesus died so we can have a one-on-one relationship with God and stand before Him unashamed. Have you trusted Jesus with your life? Another message from Lifeline Productions, the comic strip of radio, and lifelinepro.com.
Thank you. I'm
on UP987 DYFR-FM, life-changing. Broadcasting from Emmanuel Bible College compound, Banawat Hills, Cebu City.
How does God change a stubborn heart? Here's today's key for unlocking the Bible with Colin Smith.
You know, God's judgment makes the sinful heart harder. And that's why at the end of the Bible, when God's judgments are poured out, you don't find repentance, but resistance. So how does God change a stubborn heart? You know, in Isaiah, God says, I punished him, yet he kept on in his willful ways. But I have seen his ways, and I will heal him. It's as if God is saying, my judgment brought no change at all in these people, but I want to heal them, so I will show them my mercy. And that's what God has done for us in Jesus Christ. The natural inclination of your heart will be to run and hide from God. But when you are persuaded of God's mercy, you will gather the courage to repent. God's law condemns, but his love redeems.
To hear more, visit our website, unlockingthebible.org.
Coronavirus.
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 As we campaign against the spread of COVID-19, let's also campaign against the spread of fake news. Do not share unconfirmed news or posts to avoid unnecessary fear and panic. Do your research if there is something you find confusing from what you read online. Listen or read the briefings and advisories straight from the Department of Health. Together, let's fight COVID-19. Stop fake news. Stop fake news.
And our time is now 8:32 a.m. Thanks for tuning in today. You're in UP987, life-changing, heard online too through the mobile app FABC PH Stream. I'm Gail, your Monday morning companion. I like these words by inspirational speaker Francis Kong. And this is actually an excerpt from his book entitled Da, Developing Unhealthy Habits. And I quote, "Don't make a big deal out of being a slow learner. It's always better to be a slow learner than to be someone who never learns anything at all." End of quote. This is so true. You know, in the society that easily resorts to labeling and name calling, this is such a good reminder. And I hope this will help us understand each other more, understand each other better. Others are blessed to learn things fast. Some need more time to be able to do so, but at least they are learning. So if you're a leader, I hope you will do your best to understand the pace of the people under you. Instead of judging, labeling, and treating them as weaklings, why not help them and develop them? Well, some insights to ponder on this part of the day. We want to say hi to Ate Catalina Bacot and family. Thank you for always tuning in today and for the kind words you've shared about UP987. Hi to our friends at CCBC Liloan. Hi also to Pastor Felipe Singura and Pastor Fred Gulani, Pastor Alan Tan, Attorney Jojo Ortega, Pastor Joseph Press, and to the Kalamansig Sultan, to your clan at Kalamansig Sultan Kudarat, to Noitonio Katandihan family, and the kids. Wow, thank you for tuning in to UP987, and may God continually bless you and keep you. Playing now is Tori Kelly for the song Questions that's here on this FEBC radio. Listen to the message of this song, and I hope it encourages you.
FEBC
Cebu. To laugh and to cry, I struggle with the season. When you live, then you die. It's hard to play this game because the rules, they don't seem fair. If you care, God, if you're still there, bombs fall in Together so
Shut up.
DYFR-FM, life-changing, communicating Christ on air, online, and on the ground.
Hey guys, how's it going? This is Ledger. Just wanted to give you guys a bit of an encouragement. I know that times seem kind of crazy right now, unlike anything we've seen, and just want to remind you that in the Bible there are so many times where God interrupts lives, and it's always to touch hearts, to change them, to meet them in new ways, and it's usually when he's doing a miraculous and great thing. And so if you're feeling unsteady, if you're feeling uncertain, be reminded of who your God is. Be reminded that we do not have to be afraid, because he's always close by us. I just want to encourage you guys that you've got unique opportunities in these unique circumstances right now. There is nothing like comfort and complacency to kind of make us numb in our walks with God, kind of make us not necessarily feel that desperate need to cling to him and seek him. And so use this time in a great way to reprioritize your life, to put God first, to really seek him. Let this deepen your walk with him in a way like never before. Let him be the most real, the most true hope in your life. Let him be the only firm foundation that you put your hope in. He's the only thing that matters. There are many things in this world that, you know, maybe they can destroy our bodies, but they cannot destroy our soul, and they cannot destroy the hope we have in Christ our King. Be encouraged, church. These are crazy times, but he is so much bigger than all of this, and he is totally in control. Reach for him. Let's be ready to speak to people about him. Let's let him do a new thing in the name of Jesus.
That was Ledger sharing some encouraging words amid the pandemic we're facing. Indeed, there are lots of reasons to worry, panic, and doubt, but let's resolve to trust in our sovereign God, and may his peace continue to fill your heart and mind as we face uncertain times, as we face this new normal. God's got this, all right? Check your time. It's now 8:50 a.m. You're on UP987, life-changing. My name is Gail, reminding you that you are blessed for you are loved, so have faith. Enjoy the rest of the day. May God bless you.